down. I am tired.
Wolves take the lead.
Welcome out to Brazel Stadium here for the series finale between GCU and CSU Bakersfield here on a beautiful, warm, and Sunday spring Sunday afternoon in Phoenix, Arizona. I'm Fletcher Leick here calling the series finale between these two ball clubs. GCU took the first two games to snag the series and is going for the sweep here today on the mound for GCU to solidify the first series sweep of the season for GCU. In just his second collegiate start is a freshman southpaw, Jack Snyder, from Gilbert, Arizona. Schneider has a 3.18 ERA in 5 2/3 innings pitched. In his first collegiate start, he gave up only one run. It was a solo shot against a high-powered offense in New Mexico. He'll face off against an offense for CSU Bakersfield that's potent at the top and hasn't really produced at the bottom. Starting off for Bakersfield is Mark Pena. Andrew Penner in the two spot. David Metzger hitting third. Max Carter will clean things up. On the mound and hitting in the five spot is Malik Jones. Ryan Grotjohn, the shortstop, is hitting sixth. Cole Valletta, another player from Arizona, is hitting seventh. Then Austin Tengen and Junior Felix to round out the batters for the runners. Jack Schneider, in just his second start, in his last start, he threw 4 1/3 against New Mexico, gave up only two hits, one run. It was that home run. Walked three, struck out one. That's a career high. He's in just his third total appearance against for GCU. He faced off against UNLV in relief, threw an inning and a third. The first pitch from Schneider is in there for a strike. First pitch, 12-01. Jack Schneider went to Basha High School. He has a 1-1 count here to Pena, who's hitting very well so far this season and in the series. In the season, Pena's hitting .318 with 21 hits, 4 doubles and 3 triples. That one is going to get in there for a strike. And 12 RBIs to Pena's name. The only home run for the entire team is Max Carter. He hit a home run for Bakersfield. GCU has a handful of home runs. One coming in the first game of the series against the runners off Tom LaRouche's bat, a two-run shot to right field. He had all three RBIs in that game. The top of the lineup for GCU going 4 for 5. The rest of the lineup going 0 for 18 with a one walk. The bats came to life yesterday afternoon. This one's popped up. It might stay in play. Ian Evans, the first baseman, has a play on it. The only defensive changes for GCU: Ty Wyatt at third base and Quinn Cotton in left. Tom LaRouche in center. Garrison Schwartz in right. Mumper at short. Bull at second. Evans at first. And flashing the signs behind the plate is Joshua Meyer. Meyer went 1 for 3 yesterday. Scored 2 runs and had 2 RBIs. Good day for Meyer, who hasn't had a lot of ABs. That brings up Andrew Penner. Penner's hitting .462 with 24 hits and a double with 7 RBIs. He's walked 11 times, struck out 9 times. .20 count here to Penner from Schneider. The 6-foot freshman from Gilbert, Arizona, delivers. Now one just gets over the plate for strike number one. It's a 2-1 count now. Schneider pitched 82 1/3 total innings in his junior and senior year for Basha, the Bears. Just a junior and senior there. The career ERA of 2.13, striking out 103 batters, only giving up 43 walks. 3-1 just gets in there. Penner was trying to work a walk there. Nods his head back to the home plate umpire, Steve Mattingly. Joe Burleson's at first base, and Matt Stelgas is at third. The payoff pitch from Schneider is fouled back. Jack Niner's career high, 4 1/3 inning. Swing and a miss. Strike three. He's got two outs quickly here against the runners. First strikeout of the game for Schneider, and it ties a career high. Schneider got a strikeout against New Mexico on the 21st. That was his only strikeout of the season as well. Now he's got two, so he's doubled his tally just in one inning here against the runners. GCU will grab their bats here shortly. The first pitch to the new batter, David Metzger, who's playing third base today. Started at second yesterday, then moved over to third midway through the game. Metzger's hitting .338 on the season with 24 hits. The 0-1 is a changeup that gets away from Schneider and Meyer, where we'll roll the backstop. The 1-1 from Schneider is fouled out of play over Antelope Gymnasium behind the first base dugout. GCU in their all whites today. Wore them on Friday as well. They wore black yesterday. Bakersfield in their blue tops here today. The 1-2 from Schneider. Swung on and lifted left. Cotton is going to let it fall in front of him, and it's a two-out single for Metzger. Well, off the bat, Cotton got a good jump on it, was hustling in for that ball, and put on the brakes the last second, decided not to give up extra bases on a dive attempt, tried to get a SportsCenter top 10 play there, and decided to just let Metzger reach base with that two-out single. So Schneider gives up his first hit of the afternoon, but there's two outs in the inning, and he faces off against Max Carter. Big lead over there at first base. Schneider will deliver home high and outside for ball number one. Repovich, the starter yesterday, ended the inning on a pickoff that got the leadoff batter Mark Pena out after Mark Pena struck out, but then was given more life after a balk was called with nobody on and nobody out. 1-0 just misses outside to Carter. Carter, a two-way player, started the first game. Pitched 7 2/3 innings and also hit. He's playing first base today, and he played first base yesterday as well. Schneider, long look over there at first base, will deliver home. This one misses outside as well, and it's 3-0 now to Carter. Well, in the series, Carter's hitting .429, going 3-for-7 with two RBIs. He's struck out once, the 3-0. Right down the middle for strike number one. On the season, Carter's hitting .382. With 26 hits, he's got one home run and a double with 14 RBIs. Only struck out 8 times. Schneider gets his sign from Meyer, the redshirt junior, and delivers home. The runner takes off, and it's fouled back. A little hit and run applied there by Bakersfield. And it's a full count now to Carter. Let's see if the runner Metzger takes off on the pitch. Schneider will throw over just to make sure he's not moving on first movement. Malik Jones, the pitcher's on deck. 3-2 count. Schneider will throw back over. Metzger gets in safely without having to hit the ground. Carter's on base percentage .427. Schneider throws over again. Just in there safely is Metzger, though. Schneider wanted it running around the backside of the mound. Quick quick throw over to first base. Just not enough pepper on that one to get all the way over to Evans in time. Metzger gets back in safely. Multiple pickoff attempts in a row from Schneider. Yesterday, Carter went 1-for-4 with an RBI. Another throw over to first base. This one's not in time as well. Quick snap throw over. Schneider, the freshman, maybe thinking he's got to try a little bit harder than normal to make sure Metzger doesn't get any bigger of a lead. He's got a really big lead. Runner does take off, but it's ball four. Great at bat there for Carter, working that walk. Having to wait a long time between pitches as well as Schneider threw over to first base multiple times in a row. That brings up the pitcher, Malik Jones. Jones hitting 400 on the season. And 286 in the series, 2-for-7 with two RBIs. All of his hits have been singles. No extra base, three total extra base hits for the runners. Two doubles by Pena and a double from Tyler Kame, who's not in the lineup today. Malik Jones has a runner in a scoring position. With two outs in the inning, Jack Schneider getting a pop-up and a strikeout to start things off, and then has allowed the next two batters to reach base. And now make it three. Pegs Malik Jones, and he's got the bases loaded here in the first.
Now batting shortstop number 9, Ryan Grotjohn.
Brings up a dangerous batter in Ryan Grotjohn. Grotjohn's hitting 435, and that'll bring out Rich Dorman from the dugout and have a little chat with his pitcher, Jack Schneider, who might be a little rattled here. The freshman seeing his first conference opponent, and he's worked himself into a big jam here with two outs. In the series, Grotjohn has not been hitting well, only hitting 125. He's gone 1-for-8. But on the season, he's hitting very well. He was the reigning WAC player of the week, going 10-for-15 last weekend. And entering the series, was ranked in the top 10 in the NCAA Division I for batting average. Numbers dipped down a bit after going 1-for-8 so far in this series. And fun stat for you, this is the second time in the series the starting pitcher for Bakersfield has been hit in his first at-bat of the game. We like to make up stats here at GCU, specifically about GCU baseball. And that one's way inside to Grotjohn, and Jack Schneider can't find the strike zone. A lot of chirps from the Bakersfield dugout. Grotjohn hasn't thrown a strike in a long time. It's 2-0 now to Grotjohn. Four straight balls from Schneider, if you include the ball that hit Malik Jones. The 2-0 in there for a strike. 25 pitches so far through this inning. Two quick ABs against Pena and Penner. And then he's found himself in some trouble. Jack Schneider giving up a single, walking a batter, and gives up another single, and that's going to score a pair. Max Carter is in safely, and it's a 2-0 ball game here after an RBI, two RBI single from Ryan Grotjohn. That brings up Cole Valletta. Valletta, right-handed sophomore, playing in right field today, hitting 256, 10 hits, 3 runs scored, a double and 4 RBI. struck out 8 times. And GCU has a 2-0 deficit to get out of, and it's just the first inning. First pitch is at the shoulders. Josh Meyer will call time and go chat with his freshman pitcher. Seasoned catcher behind the dish, knowing when he needs to go out. Richard Jr. didn't play last year due to injury, but he's back this year. Hasn't had a lot of at-bats, but played very well yesterday, and Stankiewicz decided to go back with Meyer here this afternoon. Meyer, his first at-bat, and a 2-RBI single put GCU on the board. The 1-0 to Valletta's fouled back. Malik Jones out there at second base, and Ryan Grotjohn is at first after a 2-RBI single to make this a 2-0 ball game. Schneider slowing down the game. The 1-1 is way outside, ball two. GCU did win the series, was able to take game two yesterday. Jake Repovich, the starting pitcher, got a lot of run support from his teammates, and the bullpen was able to withstand an attempted onslaught from Bakersfield. The 2-1. Ground ball left side, Mumper's there. The long throw and deep in the hole, got him. So Jack Schneider gives up 2 hits and 2 runs, 2 left on base for Bakersfield. There were no errors. And a long throw from Mumper ends the inning. But the runners have a 2-0 ball game and a 2-0 lead here heading to the home half of the first here on GCU TV. Get the best gear to show off your Lope pride. Go to lopeshops.gcu.edu to find everything GCU. From the newest apparel to the coolest accessories, use promo code GCUTV20 to get 20% off for being a GCU TV viewer. Let's paint the valley purple. Lopes up. So Malik Jones will face off against GCU here in this one. Jones, a 6'4 righty with a 4.34 ERA, 16 strikeouts in 18 and 2/3 innings pitched. Had a career-high 8 strikeouts against Portland. Half of his strikeouts coming in one game. He'll face off against a lineup that's starting to find its stride after the last couple ball games, except for that blowout against New Mexico, 22-3 loss. Mexico scoring 51 runs over the course of 2 games, 22 against GCU, then 29 in the next game. Austin Bull will lead things off for GCU, then Tom LaRouge and Ian Evans. Those are the 3 batters guaranteed at bats in the inning against Malik Jones. Cuba Best will clean things up. Ty Wyatt will hit 5th. Garrison Schwartz is in the 6th spot. Quinn Cotton hitting 7th. Josh Meyer hitting 8th. And Mark Mumper will end things for GCU in the 9 spot. Defensively for the runners behind the plate, flashing the signs is junior Felix at 3rd base. Metzger, Grotjohn is at short. Tengins at 2nd base. Max Carter is at 1st. Across the outfield, Penner, Pena, and Valletta from left to right. Austin Bull, a switch-hitting sophomore, will face off against a 6'4 righty. Out of Palmdale, California. First pitch to Bull is a ball. Longest outing for Malik Jones, 5 2/3 innings against Portland. The 1-0 comes on the inner part of the plate for strike number 1. Career high gave up 4 earned runs against GCU last year. Also hit 2 batters in that game. So a second time facing GCU here in the last 2 years. Comes inside again. This one misses 2-1 now. And Austin Bull has been a hard out for Bakersfield. Had a perfect on base percentage until the late innings of last night's game. grounding out deep in the hole to Grotjohn twice. Grotjohn having to make two fantastic plays to get Bull out. Just shows the offensive prowess that Bull has and that he's been able to produce at the top of the lineup. He's been a steady on-base guy and a steady leadoff batter for GCU. Looks at a pitch upstairs, and he's worked himself into a full count situation here against Jones to lead things off in the first. GCU trailing 2-0 after a 2-RBI single from Ryan Grotjohn, who hadn't really done anything for the runner so far in the series. Bull lifts one to center field, but Pena's right there to snag it for out number one. Brings up Tom LaRouge. LaRouge is hitting .317 on the season in just his 10th start, his 5th start in center field on the season. 41 ABs, 13 hits, a double and a home run with 3 RBIs. Strike out just 9 times. Off-speed pitch, misses high and away. And Tom LaRouge brings more than just his bat to the lineup. His defensive ability and speed patrolling the outfield has been greatly needed, and he's shown the speed and the range and the ability to cover a bunch of ground out in center field just in this series alone, making fantastic catches, sliding, diving, running, jumping, catches all over the outfield all series long. He also did it all with his bat in game number one, having all 3 RBIs and scoring 2 runs in that game. The 2-1 is fouled out of play. It's a 2-2 count now to Tom LaRouge. LaRouge went 1-for-4 with a run scored in yesterday's ball game. Facing off against Malik Jones here with 1 out. Ian Evans is on deck. The transfer from Gateway College, who's cemented himself as the everyday first baseman. Tom LaRouge pokes one into left field, and it's a 1-out single for Tom LaRouge here in the first. Brings up Ian Evans. Evans hitting .316 on the season with 24 hits, 6 doubles and a home run with a team-leading 14 RBIs. He's tied with Garrison Schwartz for the team lead. Tom LaRouge with speed on the base paths. 1-for-2 in stolen base attempts. Hasn't really had opportunities to show his base-running ability so far this season, and just his 10th start, 17th game played. Throw over from Malik Jones to first base. Jones comes set and delivers home. Belt high for strike number one. 1-1 count. Ian Evans has played and started in every single one of GCU's ball games, 22 ball games so far this season. Swings over the top of that one. Garrison Schwartz is the only other GCU Lope to have started and played in every single ball game. Ian Evans has a 1-2 count here with a runner on first base, Tom LaRouge singling. Cuba Best, the designated hitter, is on deck. Lifted into center, and it's going to get down, a line drive single for Ian Evans, and there's runners on first and second for Cuba Best here with 1 out in the inning.
Now batting the designated hitter, number 28, Cuba Best.
Best is hitting .286 on the season with 16 hits, 3 doubles, and 6 RBIs. He's been a platooned DH with Greg Sines. Ty Wyatt's done a little bit of the job as well. Tom LaRouge was DHing for a while because he couldn't play defense because of his shoulder, wasn't able to throw the baseball for a while, but LaRouge was back in center, and Cuba Bess has been DHing. Flicks one down the line, and clatters off the top of the awning in the bullpen for GCU. RBI opportunity here for Bess with LaRouge at second. Any ball into the outfield will most likely score LaRouge unless it's a line drive that one-hops the outfielders. LaRouge with a bunch of speed out there at second base. Bess has to call time to tie his shoe. Cuba Bess is a freshman from Fruita, Colorado, went to Fruita Monument High School. The 1-1 to Bess. Inner part of the plate for strike number two. Bess didn't like it. Really on top of the plate there, really crowding it. And just sneaks in there for strike number two. 1-2 count now with runners on first and second. Two singles from LaRouge and Evans. 2-0 ball game, both teams with two hits. Well, a couple of walks and a hit batter for Schneider. Put runners on base, loaded the bases, and then Grotjohn came through for the runners. Bess has four multi-hit games for GCU. Three hits against San Francisco. Two RBIs in that game as well, scored two runs. Nice day for Bess against San Francisco. Just gets a piece of it off the end of the bat. Fouls it off to stay alive here against Jones. Big gap out in left center as the left fielder Penner is shaded towards the third baseline. The 1-2 upstairs of the head. It's 2-2 now for Bess. Bess, a big boy, hitting 286. Entered the series hitting 327. He lifts one to center. Tom LaRouge took off on first contact and had to retreat back to second base. So there's two outs in the inning after two flyouts to center. Brings up Ty Wyatt, who's playing third base today. Had been playing in left the last couple of games. But he moves to third base. Zach Malice gets the day off. Didn't get on base or record a hit for GCU. So Malice gets the day off, and Ty Wyatt, who's stroking a hot bat so far, went perfect 3-for-3 yesterday with two runs scored. And they'll play third base. And the home plate umpire, Steve Mattingly, is jawing with the Bakersfield dugout. Beard steps out of the dugout as well, chats with a couple guys sitting along the dugout fence. Mattingly is showing the ball was about a foot inside and off the plate. But the Bakersfield players didn't like it. Beard didn't like the fact that the Bakersfield players were jawing with the umpire. Wyatt swings and misses at that one. Felix keeps it in front of him, and nobody's able to go anywhere. Wyatt's hitting 262 on the season with four doubles and three RBIs. Couldn't make it four here. with the ball in the outfield. The 1-1. Lined into right center field. It's going to score one. Ian Evans is trucking for three. He's going to be sent home. The throw in. The throw from second base from Tengen. Not in time. It's a 2-2 ball game after an RBI double. Two RBI double from Ty Wyatt. So officially, it goes down as a double and an E8 is what the Athletics Communications Director Josh Meyer is saying to my right. So Ian Evans scores on a Josh Hauser. Josh Meyer's the catcher. A lot of Josh's up in here. So Ian Evans reaches third on the double, then reaches home on the E8. And Ty Wyatt has two RBIs here in this one and is looking to continue the hot streak he's had so far. He was named the GCU Players Player of the Game, given the old white helmet for his efforts yesterday. And hasn't broken stride here today. 0-2 pitch to Garrison Schwartz is outside. Quinn Cotton standing on deck with Josh Meyer in the hole. GCU sent five batters to the plate. This is the sixth. The 1-2 pitch to Garrison Schwartz, ground ball right side. Nobody's covering first base. Ty Wyatt's coming home, and it's a 3-2 ball game. Ty Wyatt's heads-up base running scores on the single by Garrison Schwartz. Didn't break stride, and that'll bring Beard out of the dugout and go chat with Malik Jones. Five runs have scored here in the first for both ball clubs. And GCU still has a runner on base. Andy Stankwitz, the head coach for GCU, will take this opportunity to chat with his freshman, Quinn Cotton. Quinn Cotton's due up. Hitting .231 on the season. Nine hits, a double and a triple, and one RBI. Started the season well. Along with Kona Quiggle. And Quinn Cotton will get an opportunity to bat and play in left field today with Malice out of the lineup and Ty Wyatt moving to third. Garrison Schwartz is at first base after his RBI single. Now clips the outer part of the plate for strike number one. The 0-1 from Jones popped up, and it's going to get out of play. Quinn Cotton out of Aurora, Colorado. Considered Oklahoma, West Virginia, Washington, and USC. GCU taking the three-game series from Oklahoma State to start things off. Oklahoma State was ranked 22nd in the country at the time, is no longer ranked. Cotton has a 1-2 count here, facing off against Malik Jones. Ball outside. Schwartz over there at first base bluffed on a stolen base attempt and then retreated back to first base. time is called. Quincon will step out and then step back in. 6-4 righty comes set on the mound. Delivers. Ground ball left side, third base side, just foul past the third base bag. Josh Meyer on deck. Had a great day yesterday, went 1-for-3. 2 runs scored, and his one hit was a double, has 2 RBIs, and was hit by a pitch, reaching base twice, scoring every time he reached base. 2-2 count here for Cotton. Runner at first is Schwartz. The delivery lined into center. Pena has to put on the brakes, and it's a single up the middle for Quinn Cotton.
Now batting, the catcher, number 24, Josh Meyer.
That brings up Josh Meyer. No movement in the bullpen for Bakersfield. Malik Jones going to be given the opportunity here. Has given up 3 runs, but only one of them is earned. Now make it 2 earned runs. Ty Wyatt's run was earned. Josh Meyer had a similar situation in his first at-bat yesterday against Bakersfield, and he doubled to score both runs. Runners on first and second here against Malik Jones. The 1-1 pitch lifted to center field. Pena is right there this time. So every single out recorded is right at Pena. GCU sends 8 batters to the dish, records 5 hits to score 3 runs, 1 error, and 2 left on base. GCU leading 3-2 here over the runners, heading to the second.
Learn the art of hospitality management at GCU, right in the heart of Phoenix, Arizona, a top tourism market bustling with opportunity for our hospitality students. Join the student team at GCU Hotel, delivering unmatched service plus amenities like the Oasis Pool, Fitness Center, and Canyon 49 Grill. Learn golf management at GCU Championship Golf Course, featuring over 7,200 yards of expansive tees and tree-lined fairways. Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Visit gcu.edu.
GCU hanging a crooked number on the board to counteract CSU Bakersfield's 2-run first. GCU puts 3 up on the board in the first. Tom LaRouge starting things off with a 1-out single. Evans did the same. And then a 2 RBI double from Ty Wyatt scored LaRouge. Ian Evans was able to reach on an E8 because of a bobble by the center fielder. And then Garrison Schwartz singled to score Ty Wyatt. A ground ball that was tricky for Tengen and Carter at first base and second in between first and second base. Nobody was covering first base. Jones was running over there, but the throw was not in time. Wyatt didn't break stride, rounding third base, came around to score. Tengen, Felix, and Pena do up for the runners here in the second inning. The first pitch is a big hanging breaking ball. Could have fit a 747 inside that hanger. And it's an 0-1 count here at Tengen. Fastball, one hopper right at Ian Evans, and Jack Schneider's got a quick out here on 2 pitches here in the second.
Now batting, catcher number 2, Junior Felix.
Go, So GCU hit the ball well back in that first inning. Every single out. Line drives right at the center fielder, Pena. The first pitch to Felix in their first strike. So Jack Schneider uses the long inning, long break between having to pitch and has come back refocused. Sometimes the opposite happens. Another big breaking ball from Schneider. And these Bakersfield hitters hadn't seen the breaking ball yet. And they haven't seen one like that before. Really slow, high arcing 12-6 curveball. Then comes in with a fastball. Foul tip into the glove of Josh Meyer. It's a second strikeout and a career high two for Jack Schneider here with a second strikeout of the game.
Now batting center fielder Mark Pena.
Back to the top of the lineup for the runners, Mark Pena. Popped up in foul territory to Ian Evans, the first baseman for GCU back in the first inning. But Schneider was able to get the first two outs of the inning relatively quickly, but then put the next four runners, batters on base, giving up a single, a walk, a hit by pitch, and then another single before getting the final out of the inning. Breaking ball is in there for a strike. It's an 0-2 count now to Pena, who hasn't been able to figure out Schneider yet so far. The 0-2 comes inside. This one's downstairs. The 1-2 from Schneider popped up out of play. So if Schneider can get out of this, he would put that inning behind him where he got the first two outs and then let the next four base runners and batters reach base, giving up two runs. He's facing off against the top of the lineup here in Pena, the 1-2. Upstairs, ball two. Strike three, and that ends the inning. Two strikeouts in the inning here for Schneider. No runs, no hits, no errors, no left on base. Three up, three down for Schneider. We head to the home half of the second here on GCU TV. GCU leading 3-2, looking to add some more runs. If you're on campus, check out GCBC for locally sourced coffee, tea, and treats. That's the Grand Canyon Beverage Company located in the Student Union, the Roadrunner Apartments, and the Canyon 49 Grill. So, due to the last inning, there's been scoring changes. All three runs that GCU scored were earned due to the way the rest of the inning went. So Malik Jones with three earned runs is one earned run away from tying a career high in four.
Leading off, bottom of the second for the Lopes. Shortstop, number 18, Mark Lumper.
GCU's Mark Mumper, the shortstop, will lead things off here in the second inning, then back to the top of the lineup with Bull and LaRouge. Mumper's 0 for 6 in the series so far. He does have an RBI on a fielder's choice from yesterday's ball game. Ground ball left side, deep in the hole, takes a courteous bounce for Grotjohn, and he makes the strong throw over to first base to retire Mark Mumper. But wow, that took a nice hop off the edge of the infield grass for Grotjohn. And it popped right shoulder level for him. He's able to grab the ball and make the throw without a too difficult throw. And that'll bring up Austin Bull. So tough luck for Mumper. Bull swings at the first pitch he sees and fouls that one off. Bull skied out to center field and hard line drive. He lines one into the corner down the left field line. Could be extra bases for Bull. It is. And he'll trot into second base with a one-out double here in the second.
Now batting, center fielder Tom LaRouge.
And that brings up Tom LaRouge, who singled and scored back in the first. Great at-bat there from Bull. Aggressiveness all the way around. And he sent the pitch on the outer part of the plate into left field. Bull's bouncing around there at second. First pitch to LaRouge is downstairs at the ankles for ball number one. GCU has a runner in scoring position here for LaRouge to hit him in. Delivery is in there for a strike. LaRouge was taking that one all the way. Good looking pitch on the outer third. Jones gets the sign from Felix. Will come set. Looks back at second base. Austin Bull's out there. Who's dancing around, delivers home. And LaRouge fouls that one off his foot. And it will trickle towards the first base dugout. LaRouge has produced as of late. He's been very beneficial for GCU here in the series and in all five of his starts defensively. And his bat was something that GCU needed to get the bats rolling. They weren't able to score a lot of runs after that Oklahoma State series. LaRouge starting in those as designated hitter. Then didn't get a lot of starts against Wichita State or St. Mary's. He's been back since the New Mexico series. Comes inside and pegs him on the back cheek. So LaRouge has reached base twice today. And it brings up Ian Evans with runners on first and second here with one out. Still no movement in the Bakersfield bullpen, but there is a catcher with shin guards on. He's been walking around the dugout, maybe getting things ready to go down there. Bull's still dancing around at second base, and he takes off for third. Hit and run applied, ground ball to the second baseman. One out at second, and the double play ends the inning. GCU tried to run out of the double play, sending both runners on first movement, but Ian Evans grounds that out into an inning-ending double play here in the second. GCU unable to score any runs after a one-out double by Austin Bull. We head to the third, GCU leading 3-2.
Earning your RN to BSN degree online doesn't have to be without the college experience. Finding your purpose takes support from those around you. GCU's leadership offers over three decades of experience delivering our accredited RN to BSN program 100% online. Graduate in as few as 16 months, learning from full-time practicing nurse faculty in small classes. Integrate your education with your faith and Christian worldview.
Find your purpose online at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. Visit gcu.edu.
GCU unable to score any runs, in the second inning, a one-out double from Austin Bull, and then a hit by pitch for LaRouge, but then an inning-ending double play, the way that GCU was able to get the last three outs, or end the last three innings of the ball game yesterday in the seventh, eighth, and ninth inning-ending double plays, and a game-ending double play. And GCU ends the second with an inning-ending double play. Either way, GCU's leading 3-2. Penner, Metzger, and Carter due up for the visitors here against Jack Schneider here in the third inning. Career high 4 1/3 innings pitched in an outing for Schneider. He settled down in the second. Let's see if he continues with his dominance here in the third. Ground ball left side, Mumper's there. The throw in time, out number one. Brings up Metzger, the third baseman, who singled and scored in the first. Scored from third base easily on the single by Ryan Grotjohn. Max Carter on deck, scored from second on that single. GCU erased the 2-0 deficit in the bottom half of the first, scoring three runs. That's where we're at right now here in the top of the third with one out. That one misses low to Metzger. LaRouge shaded the second base side of the bag out in center field. Count here to Metzger, as that one missed low as well. So there's a big gap out in left center field. Schwartz and Cotton, the corner outfielders, playing in normal positions. The 2-0. Big curveball. That stayed up high and missed. 3-0 count here for Schneider facing off against Metzger. Singled through the left side in the first, the 3-0, ball four.
Now batting, first baseman Max
brings up Max Carter, the first baseman, senior, who started the first game of the series. And when we say started, we mean started on the mound. He also hit, he's hit in every single game as well. Carter's 3-for-7 in the series with two RBIs. Jack Schneider throws his fifth ball in a row. It's a 1-0 count here for Carter. Carter's from Bakersfield, California. Schneider takes his time out on the mound, then delivers home. That one gets in there for a strike. Hit his first home run of the season against Nebraska. The 1-1 from Schneider. Comes inside, runner takes off. The throw gets away from Bull, who had it. And Metzger will get into third base. Goes down as a stolen base and an error on the catcher. So it looks like the second out of the inning is not, and now there's a runner on third base, and Max Carter has the chance to tie the ball game here. Breaking ball pulled down the third baseline by Carter. Schneider will wait for the ball to leave the field of play, and then comes set and delivers. Ground ball, third base side. Ty Wyatt will come home with the ball. There's a rundown at third. The throw back to third base. Got him. Heads up play there by Wyatt, and Beard will come out of the dugout and chat with the third base umpire, Matt Stelgis. Mumber comes home and gives a high five to Meyer. Meyer calling for the ball, got it, and then threw the ball right back to Wyatt as quickly as he got it. Beard is still having a chat with Stelgis. Justin Roberts down there at third base. Third base coach for the runners. Jonathan Johnson is the first base coach for the runners. First base coach Jonathan Johnson, third base coach Justin Roberts. Malik Jones steps in. Max Carter's at first after reaching on the fielder's choice. Schneider will throw over. So the out goes down as a 5-2-5 fielder's choice. Throw home. Gets in there on the outer part of the plate for strike number one to Jones. Jones got hit by a pitch in the first. Lifts this one to left center field. Cotton's there to retire the side. So GCU gives up a walk. But that's it, no runs, no hits, no errors. One left on base for the runners after a 5-2-5 rundown. Gets Metzger out of the inning at third base. And GCU leads this one 3-2. So we head to the bottom of the third inning here on GCU TV. Want to work on campus? GCU is hiring student workers for summer 2017. Some jobs may start as soon as this semester. Build your resume and gain real-world experience as a GCU student worker. Find a job on March 29th on the Student Union Promenade or start applying online today at gcu.edu/studentemployment. Cuba Best, Ty White, and Garrison Schwartz do up for GCU here in the third. Best flew out to center field. Wyatt, two RBI double in the first, and then scored a run on Garrison Schwartz's single. So three RBI is coming from Wyatt and Schwartz, and they're due up here in the third. Best, Bull, and Meyer all hitting the balls well so far. They were the three outs in the first inning, all fly outs to center field. Best steps in here. Facing off against Malik Jones. Still no movement in either bullpen for GCU or CSU Bakersfield. First pitch, outer part of the plate, strike number one. Best has an 0-2 count here against Malik Jones. Jones delivers out of the windup. Best flies one into left. A long run for Penner, but he'll grab that one on the edge of the warning track. Brings up Ty Wyatt. Two RBI, double and a run scored back in the first inning. Went 3-for-3 yesterday. Checks his swing, didn't go. Joe Burleson down at first base. After Steve Mattingly asks for help. Out of the windup, Jones delivered this time. That one's a strike. And now it's 1-1. The 1-1 in the dirt. And Ty Wyatt's a guy that if you need him to, he can play anywhere. Played in left, played third base, can play second, played short, has played every single position except for catcher, center, and right in his GCU career. The 2-1. Down low, ball three. Kind of like a Brock Holt utility guy who plays everywhere, except Ty Wyatt has the ability to pitch as well. The 3-1 to Wyatt. Ground ball right at Metzger, smothers it. Third baseman throws over to first base for out number two. That'll bring up Garrison Schwartz, 14 RBIs, make it 15, a team lead after an RBI single in the first inning. The first pitch to Garrison Schwartz, knee high for strike number one, good fastball there from Jones. Nobody reaching base yet so far in the third inning for GCU. Off-speed pitch just misses down low, 1-1. Garrison Schwartz started the season slowly, but it's come back to life here as of late. Swings and misses through that one. It's 1-2 now. Schwartz tabbed as the WAC preseason player of the year. Wasn't playing so hot at the beginning of the season last year either, but got hot late. And you just have to play well when it comes to WAC play if you want to win the WAC Player of the Year, because you could play out of your mind in non-conference play and not hit the ball at all in conference, and you're not going to win Player of the Year. Schwartz's 2-2 pitch from Jones. Flicks that one in right center field. Long run for Pena. And he'll grab that one. That one staying up in the air just long enough for Pena to retire the side. Three up, three down for GCU here in the third. No runs, no hits, no errors. Nobody left on base. We head to the fourth inning. GCU still leading 3-2.
Hey Phoenix, it's Thunder Dan Marley, head coach at Grand Canyon University. Coming to GCU was a great move for me. Join Antelope Nation by enrolling as an evening student at our beautiful campus in the heart of Phoenix. Earn your bachelor's, master's, or doctoral degree to take your career to the next level. Engage with industry expert instructors in small classroom settings where you can get the support you need to excel. Scholarships available. See you on campus. Go Lopes.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Visit gcu.edu/evening.
Jack Schneider coming out for the fourth. He's thrown three complete innings so far. His career high is 4 1/3 innings in an outing. And the way he's pitching as of late so far, getting out of a jam in the third and retiring the side in order in the second, Schneider might have a new career high of innings pitched, a guy that wasn't expected to be a starter for GCU this year. It looked like GCU is going to have a really solid set starting pitching staff of Jake Repovich, Jake Wong, and then Deegan Hart. But Deegan Hart hasn't produced as of expected. He got a great fall. Staff loved him, but he hasn't been able to do what he was expected or thought people thought he could do. So Jack Schneider gets his second career start, his first whack start of the year, and of his career, two breaking balls. This one is grounded towards Mumper at short. He throws over to retire Grotjohn here to lead things off in the fourth. Cole Valletta and Austin Tengen do up as well. Valletta grounded out to short to end the inning in the first inning. That one's in the dirt from Jack Schneider. Valletta hitting 250. Looks at a breaking ball there. That one just misses. 2-0 now. Jack Schneider's brought his ERA down to 4.0, or excuse me, he's gone up to 4.0 from 3.18. And the way he's been pitching, it might go down here. If he can keep throwing well, his pitch count was at 54 before this at-bat started, so it's at 57 now. Ground ball right side, just gets foul. Just to the right of the first base bag. That would have been extra bases for Valletta, could have been three. Valletta steps back in, has a 2-2 count here against Schneider. Schneider delivers, lined right back up the middle, and it's a one-out single for Valletta here in the fourth inning.
Now batting second baseman, Austin Tengen.
Brings up the second baseman, Austin Tengen. Grounded out to first base on a three unassisted put out. Evans grabbing that one for the first out of the inning. Schneider then went on a strikeout the next two. Career high three strikeouts so far in the game for Schneider. Facing off against the lefty. Runner at first base, delivers home, bunt. Wyatt's there quickly, and will throw over first base just to get an out. Looked at second base, but decided not to go there. And there's two outs now after the sacrifice bunt by Tengen.
Now batting, catcher, Junior Felix.
Brings up the number nine batter, Junior Felix. Senior struck out in the second inning. Junior Felix, the senior, so the senior striking out in the second inning. Flashing the signs again behind the plate. Was a catcher yesterday afternoon as well. Beautiful day for some baseball here. Lifted to center field, LaRouge will get underneath it. And that's the third out of the inning. So no runs on one hit, no errors, one left on base for the runners. We head to the bottom of the fourth inning. GCU still leading 3-2. Check out companies on campus next week in the Student Union. Network with different companies, learn about jobs and internships, and maybe even land a job. For more information, contact Career Services at gcu.edu or follow them on Facebook for future opportunities at facebook.com/gcucareerservices. Malik Jones has been given the reins here in the fourth with his team trailing by a run. Nobody's out in the bullpen, not even sitting out there for the visitors. GCU out hitting CSUB 6-3. Both teams have committed an error. But GCU's leading 3-2. All five runs coming in the first inning, then it's been zeros all the way across the board. Quinn Cotton, Josh Meyer, and Mark Mumper due up for GCU here in the fourth inning. Cotton singled in the first inning, but then was stranded there. Josh Meyer flew out to center to end the inning. And Mumper led things off in the second with a ground out. So one for three out of the bottom three batters here due up in the third. Excuse me, due up in the fourth. First pitch to Cotton's driven down the third first baseline, foul. Jones delivers home. That one's in the dirt. It's 1-1 now. Cotton hitting 250 on the season. On base percentage of 250 as well. And when he leads off, he's hitting 538. The 1-1. Swung on and missed just over the top of that one. Big hack there from the left fielder. Jones delivers home out of the windup. That one's way outside. 2-2 count to the freshman. Senior versus a freshman here in this matchup. Righty on righty. Jones, long look at Felix. Delivers home. Looked good. Didn't quite get it from the home plate umpire, Mattingly. It's a full count here to Cotton. Payoff pitch from Jones. Lifted down the first baseline. It's just going to get out of play. So Cotton stays alive here in this at-bat. Against Jones, fouling off a couple of pitches. GCU heads to Arizona to face off against the number six team in the country. Might not be sixth for much longer here after they've dropped two to the number one team in the country in many polls, Oregon State, up in Corvallis. Playing right now as well. Then GCU returns home to face off against Northern Colorado, who's tied with Chicago State right now for first place in the WAC, along with GCU, both teams with two wins. Chicago State picked to finish ninth, took two games from Seattle up in Seattle. Oregon State leading Arizona 6-3 in the top of the sixth inning right now. Josh Meyer fouls off the first pitch he sees here in this at-bat. And Northern Colorado took two from Cal State Bakersfield. Josh Meyer grounds to Grobjohn, gets away from the first baseman, then takes off for second base. It's going to be a hit and an error on Grobjohn. And that puts Josh Meyer at second base. Brings up Mark Mumper, the number nine batter. He's got a runner in scoring position, Josh Meyer. Aggressive base running for Josh Meyer. Almost slipped coming around first base, though. Had to get out of the way of a couple of different people, the umpire being included. First pitch to Mumper. Gets over the plate for strike number one. Mumper's hitting 083 with runners on base and 111 with runners in scoring position. Ball's outside. Good crowd here on a Sunday afternoon here on a beautiful spring day in Arizona. No wind. Perfectly blue skies. A trickle of clouds. The ball's in the dirt. Doesn't run away from Felix enough for Meyer to reach third base. Thought about it, but then retreated back to second base. Almost got caught dead to rights in between second and third. Two-one count here for Mumper. Mumper looking for his first hit of the game. Shows bunt, pulls it back. Mumper's also looking for his first hit of the series. 0 for 6 in the series, make it 0 for 7 after grounding out in the second here today. Does have an RBI on a fielder's choice yesterday. Strike out twice. Has a 3-1 count here against the senior Felix Malik Jones. And now he's walked. Junior Felix behind the plate. Throws it back to Jones.
Second baseman, Austin Bull.
And it's back to the top of the lineup for GCU. Still no movement in the bullpen for Bakersfield. One out here in the fourth. The runners on first and second for Bull. Double down the third baseline in his last at bat. Jones looks back at second base, then comes inside to Bull, who doesn't offer at it. Now there's movement down in the Bakersfield bullpen. Four people down there for the runners. Looks like a catcher and a couple of pitchers. Maybe a pitching coach as well. Beard is the pitching coach for Bakersfield, so it would be another assistant coach down there. Looks like number 33, Garrett Nimmo, moving and warming up for Bakersfield. 2-0 count here to Bull. Jones delivers home and comes inside, but it just gets enough of the plate for Mattingly to call it a strike. 2-1 count here with one out. Runners on first and second. Meyer reaching on a single, then getting to second base on an E6. And Mark Mumper walking. Bulls hitting 278 with runners in scoring position, 312 with runners on base. Spin turn to second, Josh Meyer gets in safely. Jones steps back on the rubber and Bull steps back into the batter's box. Jones delivers home. Comes inside. This one is a ball. Looked pretty good. Looked very similar to the last pitch that Mattingly called a strike, but this time he calls it a ball. 3-1 count, and Jones is in danger of loading the bases and Tom LaRouge up next. Jones steps off. Bull steps out. Meyer retreats to second base. Doesn't want to get picked off here. Mumper with a wide stance. At first, right next to Carter, the first baseman. Jones steps off again. A little cat and mouse game going on right now on the mound. And with Meyer at second base, Jones doesn't want to make a mistake here to Bull, because he could blow this game wide open. 3-1 count with one out in the inning. 3-1. That one's a good pitch there from Jones, and that's a strike. Full count here for Jones. Only had one complete inning where he's gone three up, three down without allowing a base runner. GCU scored three runs in the first, unable to do so with a runner on second base in the second, and is trying to score with runners on first and second here. Ground ball right side is going to get through. Meyer's going to score easily, and it's going to be runners in the corners here after a single by Bull. That brings up Tom LaRouge with runners on the corners. Austin Bull's 2-for-3 today with an RBI and a double. Felix goes over the signs with his infield here in a first and third situation. LaRouge steps in. Jones taking his time out there on the mound, getting a sign from Felix, then delivers home. LaRouge attacks the first pitch he sees and fouls out of play. The runners were moving on the pitch with that 3-2 count to Bull, and Bull put it in play past the dive of Carter. Got into the outfield, and Meyer was able to score easily. Interesting decision there from Jones. Does the old third to first pickoff attempt. And that'll bring Beard out of the dugout. And it's going to be the end of Jones's day here with an 0-1 count. Giving way to number 33, Garrett Nimmo. And a Temecula, California. Jones leaves responsible for the runners on first and third, has four earned runs right now, a career high.
Now pitching for Bakersfield, number 33, Garrett Nimmo.
Nimmo's a senior at Temecula, California, went to Temecula Valley High School. Career high, seven innings pitched. Coming last year against Chicago State. Gave up nine hits against Nebraska this year. Has a 4.91 ERA coming into the series. 1.82 whip. And he's has a .388 batting average against with runners on base. Tom LaRouge still has an 0-1 count here against a new pitcher. Ian Evans is on deck with Cuba Best in the hole. GCU's looking to add some more runs here with one out in the inning. GCU, Northern Colorado and Chicago State, each with two wins on the season. Chicago State 2-1, taking the series from the projected winners of the WAC, Seattle. So the number 9 team taking on the number one team in the preseason polls and taking them down in Seattle. Big series win for Chicago State, and then Northern Colorado taking on Sacramento State and was able to take two games of that series as well. Looking for the sweep here this afternoon. Oh-1 count here for Tom LaRouge. Bunts one backwards, and a little safety squeeze was put on there by GCU. Nobody was able to go anywhere because the ball was fouled back. So LaRouge most likely not bunting now with an 0-2 count. Still with runners on first and second, there's one out. Ball's up and outside. GC leading 4-2. Five more hits than the visitors. Eight total hits for GCU here so far. The 1-2. Lifted to left center. It's going to be extra base for LaRouge. It's going to score at least one. Ball kicks around. Bulls coming home. The throw, not in time. A two RBI double from Tom LaRouge. It's a 6-2 ball game.
First baseman Ian Evans.
Brings up Ian Evans. Austin Bulls scored a run, has an RBI. Ian Evans singled and scored in the first. Ty Wiley with two RBIs. Garrison Schwartz with an RBI. Offensive numbers all around for GCU. First pitch to Ian Evans is in there for a strike. The 0-1 from Nimmo, breaking ball. Evans did well to wait on it and then fouled out of play. The 0-2 from Nimmo to Evans. Down low. Sacramento State taking game two most likely, up 7-2 over Northern Colorado right now. So if GCU is able to win this one, they'd stand alone in first place in the conference. The 1-2 to Evans fouls it off again, this time same spot. Down the first baseline out of play. Whack not starting the way the coaches thought it would finish, with Northern Colorado and Chicago State taking series from the first and third place teams that received the most coaches' polls points in the preseason polls for the WAC. New Mexico State not playing conference games this weekend. Facing off against UC Santa Barbara this weekend, splitting the first two games of the series in the rubber match here today. The 2-2 to Evans. Strike three called. So a pitch on the outer part of the plate gets Evans, and that's the second strikeout of the inning. the first for Nimmo. Brings up Cuba Best, who's 0 for 2 today, two flyouts. Best laces one into left field, long run for Penner. The dive, the slide, and the catch. Out number three. Three loud outs for Best here in the game. Two flyouts to left. That one Penner really had to work for. But not before GCU plates a handful of runs. Three runs scored. It's a 6-2 ball game here against the runners of CSU Bakersfield. Jack Schneider's out for the fifth. Looking for a career high in innings pitched in an outing here on GCU TV.
I'm Dominique. I'm a student here at Grand Canyon University studying hospitality management. My hospitality courses here are giving me a high quality education from professors that I know have been successful. Being able to work while I'm in school has enriched my college experience. I feel like I know where I'm going and what I want to do. When they say find your purpose, they mean it.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. Visit gcu.edu.
Welcome back out to Brazel Stadium here. Fletcher Like on the call for today's game. GCU looking to sweep the series, and they're doing exactly that so far. Up 6-2 on the visitors from CSU Bakersfield. Jack Schneider back out for the fifth inning and is two outs away from setting a new career high for innings pitched in an outing. And just a second career start for GCU. His first career start against a conference opponent here in game three of the first series of the season against WAC opponents. GCU looking to stand alone at first place if they can sweep the series from Bakersfield. The first pitch to Grotjohn. Pena is outside for ball number one. Pena, Penner, and Metzger do up here in the fifth inning. So Schneider will have to run through the lineup for the third time here against the top half of the lineup for CSU Bakersfield. Pena swings through that one. Big swing and a miss there from the leadoff man for Bakersfield. The 1-1 from Schneider comes inside, drops at the toes, 2-1 now. Schneider's pitched well, haven't seen a breaking ball from him in a while. He's gone with the fastball and the changeup more here as of late. The 2-1, that's the breaking ball we've seen earlier, and that one is going to be a called strike. Not very emphatic from Mattingly, and Payne didn't really like it, but it's 2-2 now. Redshirt junior facing off against the freshman. Freshman shakes off a sign, shakes off another sign, and agrees with this one, delivers home. Another breaking ball. That one looked better than the first, but it's a full count. Jack Schneider comes down on the mound, will deliver home. Fastball swung on, Mumper there, the throw over first base, and another out. So the first out is retired here in the fifth, and Schneider's tied a career high, 4 1/3 innings pitched. Good pitch count for Schneider as well, coming into that at bat with 60 pitches. Faces off against Penner here, 66 total, make that 67, and that's a strike. That one looked farther outside than the breaking ball that Mattingly called a ball, which would have been strike three against Pena. The 0-1 lifted right center field. Garrison Schwartz is there, camps underneath it, pops a tent, and catches it for out number two. Brings up the third baseman, David Metzger. Metzger's 1-for-1 today with a run scored and has reached base three times today. Walked in the third, singled in the first, was stranded. Well, got in a rundown at third base, not stranded at third. On a ground ball to Wyatt at third. Wyatt threw home, and Meyer threw back to third base. A great slide back into third from Metzger, and it didn't look like Wyatt applied a tag, but the third base umpire, Matt Stelgis, called Metzger out, and that was a second out of the inning. And GCU went on to end the inning two batters, the next batter, with Malik Jones flying out to left to end any threat of the Bakersfield runners scoring any runs. 2-0 clips the outer part of the plate for strike number one. It's 2-1 now with two outs in the inning. Jack Schneider has a career high, 4 2/3 innings pitched. Looking to make it 5. Flies out of play, 2-2. The 2-2, outside ball 3. Full count now for Schneider, facing off against Metzger, the 3-hole hitter. Schneider using a lot of pitches to keep these Bakersfield runners off balance. Strike 3 called, the 4th strikeout of the game for Schneider, and he gets through the 5th unscathed. No runs, no hits, no errors. 3 up, 3 down for Schneider and Bakersfield here in the 5th. We head to the bottom of the 5th on GCU TV. GCU leading 6-2. Get the best gear to show off your Lope pride. Go to lopeshops.gcu.edu to find everything GCU. From the newest apparel to the coolest accessories, you can use promo code GCUTV20 to get 20% off for being a GCU TV viewer. Let's paint the valley purple. Lopes up. Jack Schneider have a day. 4 strikeouts for Schneider. 5 innings pitched. Career highs in both categories. Only given up 3 hits. Great day for this freshman starting on the mound. Just for the second time in his career for GCU. Only given up 2 walks. For Schneider. Which would be a career low in a start if he were to come out. There is movement down in the bullpen. A lefty moving for the Lopes. Looks to be Gabe Benavides down working there for GCU. Could be the end of the day for Jack Schneider, the freshman. Don't want to have him go too long. Pitch counts at 74 right now. 45 strikes, his ERAs move down to 3.37, a team ERA of 3.53. First pitch to Wyatt is a ball. Wyatt 1-for-2 today. Doubled with 2 RBIs and scored a run in the first inning. In his third at bat this time. His first against Nimmo, and lines one up the middle. The dive by Tengen bounces off the glove. And it's a single to lead things off here in the 5th inning for Ty Wyatt.
Top batting right fielder Garrison Schwartz.
Brings up Garrison Schwartz here with a runner on first base, the lefty playing in right field. He has 1-for-2 today with a single and was stranded at second base. He also has an RBI. Scored Ty Wyatt on a single past the dive of both the first baseman Max Carter and the second baseman Tengen. Throw to first base was not in time, and Wyatt, not breaking stride from second base, scored on the play. The 1-0 to Garrison Schwartz. Good breaking ball pitch there from Nimmo. And it's strike number one. Nimmo comes set, has a 1-1 count against Schwartz. Comes outside. All six runs have been accredited to Malik Jones, giving up eight hits, striking out one, walking one, and left with runners on base, and is responsible for them, and they scored. Garrison Schwartz up the middle, runners on first and second for GCU with no outs in the inning, and they might have something here in the bottom of the fifth.
Not batting, left fielder, Quinn Cotton.
Brings up Quinn Cotton, who's 1-for-2 today with a single up the middle in the first inning. Struck out in the fourth. He has runners on first and second here. Corners are in. Middle infield is in double play depth. Bakersfield expecting a bunt here from Quinn Cotton. Bunt is shown. Bunt gets down, third base side. Metzger gets it, throws over to first base in time for the out, but the runners move up to second and third on the sacrifice bunt by Quinn Cotton. Great sacrifice bunt by Cotton as well, high bouncer that Metzger and Nimmo had to talk about. Metzger decided to take it and made a strong throw over to first base with Tengen covering. Cut Tengen was in time to catch the ball and step on the bag for the out. There's one out, and there's runners on second and third now for Josh Meyer. Laced into right center field. It's going to score one for sure. Garrison Schwartz is going to be held at third base. Runners on the corners now after an RBI single by Josh Meyer, his first RBI of the day. He's 2-for-2. 2-for-3. 2-for-2 in his last AB, two at-bats. Brings up Mark Mumper. Mumper's 0-for-1 today, walked and scored in the fourth. See what Mumper can do here. Is one hitting. Looks at a first pitch in there for a strike. Entered the series hitting 167. He's hitting 162 now, hitting 083 with runners on base and 111 with runners in scoring position. Garrison Schwartz down there at third, Myers at first base. The 0-1 from Nimmo. Little bouncer, double play opportunity. Only one out at second base. No throw over at first, so fielder's choice, and there's still runners on first and third base.
Second baseman, Austin Bull.
Back to the top of the lineup for GCU, it's Austin Bull. Bull is 2-for-3 today. A double in the second, and a single in the fourth, and a run scored. Singling past the dive of Max Carter, just getting underneath the glove. Tom LaRouge is on deck. Runner takes off. Throw over the top of the head of Grotjohn, but he gets there. The throw home, got Garrison Schwartz at home. GCU tried to push a run across, manufacturing a run, forcing the throw home after the throw to second base was high. Grotjohn had to jump for it. Looks like he was going to get into center field. And Schwartz was going to score easily. But Grotjohn, athletic enough to jump up and grab it, come down with it, and threw it home. Garrison Schwartz was out at the plate. GCU leading 7-2 after scoring a run on an RBI single by Josh Meyer. Gabe Benavides out on the mound here on GCU TV.
Grand Canyon University. Private, Christian, affordable. Visit gcu.edu.
Gabe Benavides out on the mound in relief for Jack Schneider. Have a day, Jack Schneider. Five innings pitched, only giving up two runs, striking out three, career highs for strikeouts and innings pitched, only giving up two walks on three hits. A great day for Schneider, only giving up two runs in the first, then put up zeros the rest of the way. Gabe Benavides comes on with a 6.57 ERA. A sophomore out of Wilcox, Arizona. Arizona, wow. Seventh game for Benavides. Eight strikeouts. Opponents are hitting 352 off of him. Leading off for the runners is Max Carter, who's hitting 562 when he's leading off. Opponents are hitting 462 from the leadoff spot against Benavides. Benavides has thrown in 12 and a third innings pitched. 19 hits, 11 runs, 9 of them earned. Strikeout 8, giving up 3 doubles and 2 home runs. Max Carter. Malik Jones is now the designated hitter, and Ryan Grotjohn due up for the runners. The first pitch from Benavides, a hanging breaking ball. That's strike number one. So lefty leaves a lefty, and Max Carter swings at the fastball and puts it into left field for a leadoff single.
Now batting, Malik Jones.
It brings up Malik Jones, who's now the designated hitter after being relieved by Nimmo. The fourth hit of the afternoon for the runners. They trail 7-2 here against GCU. GCU looking to sweep the series here as we're in the sixth inning of work between the two clubs. GCU taking the first game and the second. And now looking for the third. Benavides comes set and will deliver home. Comes inside, gets away from Meyer, the throw down to second base. Carter's out by a long shot. That ball never really got away from Meyer completely. And Carter didn't get a good jump on that one or didn't read it very well out of in the dirt. Because Meyer had all the time in the world to make a perfect throw, and that's exactly what he did. So Max Carter singles to lead things off, then is caught stealing for the first out. Benavides comes home. That's a strike, 2-1. The 2-1 from Benavides. Breaking ball, ground ball, right at Wyatt. Wyatt will make the throw. Didn't have a lot of pace on it, but gets there in time, and that's two outs here in the sixth. Brings up Ryan Grotjohn. One for two today with two RBIs. An RBI, two RBI single up the middle. in the first inning, scored Metzger and Carter. Those are the first two runs of the game, and those are the only runs so far for Bakersfield. Grochon's hitting 437. .606 slugging percentage for the shortstop. The 2-0 line drive just over the glove of Mumper. Slide from Cotton, and the quick throw in keeps that a single. Two out single by Grochon just over the top of the glove of Mumper.
Now batting right fielder Cole Valletta.
Benavides looks over at first base, delivers home, lifted to right, and Schwartz is there. Has enough time to set a cooler down, make a sandwich, pop up a tent, catch the ball, four out number three. We head to the bottom of the sixth inning, GCU leading 7-2 still. Perfect almost for Benavides, giving up two singles, only facing four batters though. We head to the bottom of the sixth inning for GCU, back to the top of the line for GCU here in the inning. You are invited to see some of the best dunkers and sharpshooters in college basketball at GCU Arena. Witness some of the best college players compete in front of a national audience in the State Farm College Slam Dunk and Three-Point Championships on March 30th. Dwayne Russell, GCU's point guard, will be competing in the Three-Point Championship competition. Bull, LaRouge, and Evans do up. Bull had his at-bat cut short in the fifth when Garrison Schwartz was caught stealing from third base, trying to go home. Mark Mumper took off on the throw. The throw to second base looked like it was going to be high, but an athletic move by Grochon, the shortstop, snagged the ball out of the air, and then he threw it home in time to get Schwartz at the plate.
Leading off the bottom of the sixth for the Lopes, second baseman Austin Bull.
So Austin Bull in his fifth plate appearance, but only his fourth at bat. Bull's been on a tear lately, hitting .381 on the season, .459 on base percentage, and he's hitting .600 when he's leading off. GCU is 8-for-14, hitting .571 with runners on base, 5-for-11 with runners in scoring position, so they're hitting .455. And GCU is 3-for-6 with two outs. The 2-0 to Bull. Just missing outside, ball three. Nimmo's pitch count at 24. And number 34, Isaac Meza, is moving down in the bullpen for Bakersfield. The 3-0 to Bull just gets in there for a strike on the outer part of the plate. 3-1, Bull was taken all the way. Nimmo comes set and delivers home. Inside ball four, 5-pitch walk to Bull, and it puts Bull on base for the third time today.
Center fielder Thomas LaRouge.
Brings up Tom LaRouge, the center fielder for GCU. 2-for-2 today with two RBIs and a run scored. A single in the first, hit by a pitch in the second, and a double in the fourth. Swings at the first pitch he sees and misses it. Rouge is back in the lineup after missing a majority of the season so far. Little slow line drive at the second base. Grosjean cuts it off, and then it's double play. 6-3 double play. And there's two outs in the inning. Brings up Ian Evans with two outs. Struck out in his last at bat. He was looking. Nimmo's first strikeout of the game. The 0-1 to Evans. Lifted to center. Pena will get there. That's the third out of the inning. So three up, three down, but GCU does get a base runner. And then it's retired on a 6-3 double play. No runs, no hits, no errors. We head to the seventh inning. GCU leading 7-2 over Bakersfield.
Grand Canyon University's newly remodeled golf course is thriving in the heart of Phoenix, featuring over 7,200 yards of expansive tees and tree-lined fairways, signature par threes, greenside bunkers, premium greens, and a brand new clubhouse and restaurant. Experience a university championship golf course this summer with great rates as low as $15 available now. Book your tee times at gcugolf.com.
Welcome back out to Brazos Stadium. Gabe Benavides back out on the mound for GCU here in the seventh inning. Pitched well in the sixth, gave up two hits, but only faced four batters. Max Carter led things off in the sixth with a single, but then was caught stealing on a ball that got in the dirt, and Josh Meyer was able to track it down quickly enough and throw out the runner at second base. GCU leading 7-2. Tell you how it happened in the first. Bakersfield scored two runs on a two RBI single by Ryan Grosjean, scoring Metzger and Carter. Then GCU put a three spot up of their own in the inning. LaRouge singling with one out. Evans doing the same. Both came around to score on a two RBI double by Ty Wyatt. Then a single, an infield single to be exact, by Garrison Schwartz, scored Wyatt from second base. Then in the fourth, GCU scored three more runs, a one-out single by Meyer, and then a walk to Mumper. A single by Austin Bull scored Josh Meyer. And then a double by Tom LaRouge scored Bull and Mumper. GCU then scored another run in the fifth inning, a leadoff single by Ty White. He came around to score on the single by Josh Meyer. First pitch from Benavides to Austin Tengan. He has a strike. Tengan's 0-for-1 today. That pitch misses outside, 1-1 now. Sacrifice bunt back in the fourth inning. Ground ball. Bull cuts it off. Can't find it out of his glove. It's stuck inside the webbing. And it's an infield single for Tengan. So tough break for Bull and GCU there, specifically for Benavides, gives up his third hit of the game on a ball that Bull can't get out of his webbing. You can see it right there, stuck in between the eye webbing of his glove. Brings up the number nine batter, Junior Felix, who's being pinch hit. Excuse me, no he's not. Still Junior Felix out there. Looks different for some reason this time through. Maybe it's the way that he's put his socks on. Quick pick over to first base, not in time. Benavides delivers home, breaking ball upstairs. Benavides threw a lot of innings over the course of the summer in summer league ball and might be used as a starter here. Has started a game for GCU this season. Didn't last very long in his start against Pepperdine, though. Felix fouls that one off. It's 2-1 now. Runner at first base. Austin Tengen singling. Jack Schneider threw brilliantly to start things off. Throw over to first. Threw five innings, only giving up three hits. Only gave up two runs. Struck out four. Career high for Schneider in both categories of innings pitched and strikeouts. 2-1, delivers home. Inside, ball three. GCU leading 7-2, have doubled the amount of hits that Bakersfield has with 12. The 3-1 from Benavides. Swung on and missed, it's 3-2 now. Benavides finished last year with a 3.18 ERA, only threw 17 total innings. This year already has 12 and a thirds innings pitched. Make it 13 and a thirds innings pitched after our last inning. And an ERA of 6.08. The payoff pitch from Benavides. Lifted. And it'll stay in the ballpark. Got underneath it. Stays in the air a long time. LaRouche tracks it down, and that's out number one.
Center fielder, Mark Pena.
Brings up Mark Pena, the center fielder for the runners. He's 0 for 3 today. Popped up in foul territory in the first, struck out in the second, and grounded out to short in the fifth. Pena's 3 for 10 in the series with two doubles. Started well in the series, but hasn't been hitting well here against the lefties for GCU. The 0-1 lifted to left. Long run for Cotton. He gets there. That one hung up in the air just enough to stay in the yard. There's two outs on two loud fly balls.
Left fielder, Andrew Penner.
Brings up the left fielder, Andrew Penner. He's also 0 for 3 today. He's 3 for 9 in the series, was hitting 500 entering the game in the series. Hitting 333 now with two runs scored and three singles. Also walked twice and got hit by a pitch on base percentage. Now at 500. Breaking ball gets in there on the outer part of the plate for strike number one. Benavides still has a runner on first base. It's Austin Tengen. After Tengen singled on a ground ball to second base, but it got stuck in Austin Bull's glove and was unable to pull it out. Benavides pitching well so far, giving up three hits. But two outs in the inning here. Popped up. It's going to stay in the yard. And it should be the end of the inning. Bull running around all over the place. That's out number three. Benavides gives up three hits total through two innings pitched. But nothing hurt so far. And GCU heads to the bottom of the seventh inning. As we stretch here at Brazel, GCU leading 7-2. Get ready to laugh out loud. Comedian and singer-songwriter Tim Hawkins is coming to GCU Arena April 1st for his April Fool's Day comedy concert. Show is guaranteed to entertain your whole family. Tickets start at just $18 with meet and greet options available. Go to the arena box office or gcuarena.com. Student discounts and group discounts are available. New pitcher for Bakersfield here as we finish up. Take me out to the ball game. It looks like number 34, Isaac Meza.
Great job, Lopes fans.
A freshman from Valencia, California. 6'3", 225, righty.
Coming in for the Roadrunners, behind the plate, number 3, Jake Ortega. And pitching, number 34, Isaac Meza.
Meza has a 4.91 ERA. This is his fourth appearance. Has a 1-0 record in 3 2/3 innings pitched. Five runs scored against him. Two earned, two walks, two strikeouts, giving up a double and a home run. Faced 21 batters. Cuba Vest will lead things off here in the inning. Hitting 300 from the leadoff spot. Hitting 271 on the season with a 317 on base percentage. Ground ball right side, right at Tengen. Throw is off the bag, and it gets away from the first baseman and out of play. And Cuba Bess will glide into second base on an E4. Brings up Ty Wyatt, who's 2 for 3 today with a double and a single and two RBIs and two runs scored. Don't be surprised if he wins GCU Baseball Player of the Game again. Team giving him the white old batting helmet for his efforts yesterday. Went 3 for 3 with two runs scored. Runner on second base here for him. Could be three RBIs. Looks at a fastball in the inner third. GC leading 7-2. Putting up three runs in the first and in the fourth. Fastball almost gets away from the catcher. Catcher is Jake Ortega. The 1-1 to Wyatt. Breaking ball, changeup. Just stays up. Ty Wyatt. He's played well so far, played at every position too, except for behind the plate and in right and in center. And he lines one into left field and is going to put runners on the corners here after Ty Wyatt's third hit of the day.
Right fielder Garrison Schwartz.
Brings up Garrison Schwartz, who's 2 for 3 today with two singles and an RBI. He's caught stealing, trying to score in the fifth inning to push the lead to 8-2. It ended the inning as well while Austin Bull was at the plate. The first pitch from Meza. Lined at the left fielder. The catch by Penner, the throw home. It's going to get cut off, and it's going to be a sacrifice fly for Garrison Schwartz. Brings up Quinn Cotton, who's 1 for 2 today. Singled in the first, struck out in the fourth, and laid down a sack bunt in the fifth. Fastball First pitch is outside and low for ball number one to the left fielder, Quinn Cotton. Was asked to play summer league baseball by Andy Stankiewicz and his staff and jumped on the opportunity to play for Aniana out in the New York area. He's come to GCU and has played some quality time here as a freshman. He has runners on first base after the sacrifice fly, and he drives one to center field. Pena is running after and grabs it. That's out number two, and Wyatt will have to go back to first base.
Catcher Josh Meyer.
Brings up Josh Meyer, who's 2-for-3 today with an RBI and a run scored. Two singles for Meyer. Meyer might keep the catcher job, the everyday catcher job, after his performances from the last two games. Don't be surprised if he starts next series against Northern Colorado. Might throw Barnes or McDonald behind the plate against Arizona in the weekday game against in-state school Arizona, who's about to get swept by the number one team in the country at Oregon State. Top of the eighth, down 11-3. Oregon State quality program. Ground ball on a one hopper. Grotjohn slips the throw to first base, gets away from the first baseman, and Wyatt will stand up at third base on the error by the shortstop. Brings up Mark Mumper with runners on first and third base. Mumper is 0-for-2 today. Walked and scored in the fourth. The only time he moved past first base, reached first base in the fifth on a fielder's choice. On what looked like a tailor-made double play ball, but Bakersfield second baseman Tengen never threw the ball at first base. He just grabbed the ball and held on to it. RBI opportunity for the shortstop here for GCU. Fouls that one off. Just got underneath it, but looked like he was on top. Looked like he was on it, though. Timing pretty well. The 14 hits for GCU so far today. Ties a season high of 14 hits coming last Tuesday. The bats have come alive lately. So over the course of less than a week, GCU's put 14 hits up on the board in two separate games. Division I record for hits in a game is 28. That's going to be really tough to beat. 28 runs, hits coming against Bradley when GCU scored 30 runs in one game against Bradley in 2015. .29 RBIs in that game, had 8 doubles, 4 home runs, 50 total bases for GCU in that game, also drew 11 walks. Bradley then went on to make the NCAA postseason that year, which is interesting when GCU scored 30 runs on him in one game. Swing and a miss, strike three. That ends the inning here in the seventh. Mumper going down on strikes. Swinging at that one, that's a first strikeout for Meza here in the game. GCU leaves two runners on base, but does score a run in the inning. It's 8-2, heading to the top of the eighth here on GCU TV.
Hello, Phoenix. This is Jerry Colangelo from Grand Canyon University. You can join the GCU community by enrolling as an evening student at our beautiful campus in the heart of Phoenix. earn your bachelor's, master's, or doctoral degree to take your career to the next level. Engage with industry expert instructors and get the support you need to excel. I look forward to seeing you on campus.
Find your purpose at Grand Canyon University. Visit gcu.edu/evening.
Jeremy Smith out on the mound for GCU, the right-hander. Steps in relief for Benavides and the starter, Jack Schneider. Benavides finishing with two innings pitched. Didn't allow a run to score. Giving up three hits, facing eight batters. Getting four flyouts. Throwing 23 total pitches, 14 for strikes. His ERA moved down to 5.65. GCU only giving up six hits, and Bakersfield's committed four errors, two by the shortstop. Shortstop Grote, John, committing two errors here in the game. Not something we saw earlier in the series when Grotjohn would make amazing plays out at shortstop, making plays that some would think don't deserve to be made at the collegiate level, but he was making them. And he hasn't been able to make them so far today, but he's had to make some tough plays over there at short as well, so you can't say he hasn't tried hard or had to make tough plays. The air is coming on tough plays as well, slipping on the last one. First pitch to David Metzger. The third baseman is in there for a strike. Max Carter and Malik Jones do up as well. Pitch is outside from Jeremy Smith. A transfer from San Jacinto College, originally from Menifee, California. The 5'11 righty throws that one over for a strike. Pitched very well against UNLV. Had some nasty breaking balls and off-speed pitches that were fooling UNLV batters. That one stays up and inside. It's 2-2. Smith got the victory in that 11-inning game against UNLV on the 14th of March. Pitched two scoreless innings, striking out four. And that one just gets over the top of the glove of Mumper. A single here for Metzger to lead things off. Great piece of hitting there by Metzger to get in front of that one and put it over the top of the jumping glove of Mumper. Brings up Max Carter. Carter's 1-for-2 today with a walk and a run scored. He was caught stealing back in the sixth inning after a single to lead things off. Got to run our first base here with no outs. Smith looks back at the runner at first, then throws a ball up in the zone at the chin. Max Carter's started every game so far this series, starting at pitcher and batting in the lineup, and then played first base both games thereafter. And he's got a 3-0 count here against Jeremy Smith. Both Smith and Carter playing summer league ball up in the Northwest League. Max Carter for the Kelowna Falcons up in Kelowna, Canada. And Jeremy Smith playing for the Gresham Grey Wolves with Gabe Benavides. Mumper played there for a little bit. Runner takes off on the 3-1 pitch. The throw down to second. is not needed. It was a walk. So a walk puts Max Carter on, and there's a runner on first and second now.
Designated hitter, Malik Jones.
You gotta keep him on the edge of your seat. So you gotta leave him with that, ooh, ah, what happened? And there's a walk, and there's runners on first and second now for Jones, who started as the pitcher, but now he's the DH. And if I'm not mistaken, he technically could go back out and pitch again, because he technically hasn't left the game. It's possible, but not probable. Yeah, he kind of got smacked around a little bit, giving up six earned runs on eight hits. Has a 1-1 count here. He's 0 for 2 today and got hit by a pitch in the first inning. Smith hasn't been able to find the strike zone so far in the inning. 2-1 count here to Jones with runners on first and second. Still a beautiful day here at Brazel. Swing and a miss there from Jones. Blue skies, streaks of clouds out in center, but that's about it. Palm trees popping out there behind, in front of the blue sky. Smith comes set, delivers home. 2-2, just low. See if the runners are going here on the pitch with a 3-2 count. Might try to stay out of a double play here. Runners don't go. Ground ball, double play opportunity. Wyatt goes to 3-for-1. The throw to first base, not in time. So Metzger's out at third base. Max Carter moves up. And Malik Jones reaches on that ball put in play. Wyatt did well to get to third base quickly, but the throw just not in time. Close bang bang play over there at first base. Great job by the camera crew to get that one. Runners on first and second still. The first pitch to Grotejohn is in there for a strike. So Jones and Carter move up on the fielder's choice. The 0-1 is low for ball one. 1-1 count now for Jeremy Smith here against dangerous hitter and Grotejohn, who hasn't been hitting very well so far in the series. Entered the series hitting very well, reigning WAC player of the week. Then went 1-for-8 in the first two games, but he's 2-for-3 here today. Swings and misses at that one. It's 1-2 now. Hitting 3-for-11 in the series. Hitting .429 with runners in the scoring position, .444 average for the season. The 1-2 from Smith. Lined in the center field. It's gonna get down in front of LaRouge. The throw home is cut off by Mumper. Throw back to third base, not in time, bases loaded. So that ball was shallow enough that Max Carter was not thinking about scoring on it. He tried and thought about it for a little bit, then changed his mind. It's probably smart. LaRouge doesn't have the greatest of arms after having to rehab his shoulder from an injury last year. But Mumper cut it off and Carter threw on the brakes and retreated back to third base. The infield will come in. Evans coming in a little bit late to the tea party. Meyer running over some things with his infield and Smith, the pitcher. Everybody looks to be on the same page. Bases are loaded here with one out. GCU leading by six. But this could become a very different ball game here with a pinch hitter, Sergio Robles, batting. The first pitch to Robles is in the dirt, smothered by Meyer, kept in front of him. Rich Dorman will come out of the dugout, call time, and go chat with Smith, and Meyer's walking out with him. Bobby Malacki is down there in the bullpen, moving for GCU, transfer from Hutchinson from Lake Havasu City, Arizona. Went to Lake Havasu High School. Got beat up a little bit against New Mexico in that second game, but every pitcher for GCU got beat up a little bit in that game against New Mexico, scoring 22 runs against the Lopes. Mattingly will go break up the mound visit. Trot back to home plate, as will Meyer. And we'll play some more baseball here on a beautiful Sunday afternoon in West Phoenix. Bases are loaded for the runners. Jeremy Smith facing off against Robles. Hitting 0-53 on the season. Pops one up, it's gonna stay in the ballpark, but just gets into the dugout. Meyer running after it, and was in enemy territory there. Robles now has a 1-1 count, just staying alive there. Could have ended his at bat very quickly. Smith comes set, the bases are loaded. The delivery home, ground ball. One hop to Bull for one at two. The double play, not in time, a run scores. Got the force at second. Looked pretty good at first, but Robles legs it out. Looked pretty clear cut from our angle. Here's the replay for you. The out at second base was for sure, and the out at first base looked pretty dang close. But Ian Evans looked to have grabbed the ball before Robles was even close to the bag. Pinch hitting for the runners is number 23, Tyler Kame. So the run scores, Max Carter coming in to score on the fielder's choice. Runners on the corners now for Kame. And a bunch of fielder's choices here in the inning. Only one hit, two hits. Metzger and Grotejohns singling. Tyler Kame was hitting 500, went 1-for-2 yesterday. Got hit by a pitch as well. Scored a run in the game yesterday as well. Seeing his second game here against GCU. Fouls that one off, staying alive here. It's 2-1. First two batters for CSU Bakersfield are 0-for-8 today. Grotejohns 3-for-4, Metzger's 2-for-3, and Max Carter's 1-for-2, along with Tengen, but his day is done. Three-one count here for Tyler Kame. Smith working out a jam. The runner takes off from first base. Hot shot into the dugout. Watch out there, Cuba Bess. Preston Pavlika, don't injure your other arm. Yeah, you. Cuba Bess having to dive out of the way on that one. Looks like everybody's okay, though. Runner takes off again, swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. Tyler came striking out. Jeremy Smith gets out of that one with just one run crossing the plate on a couple of hits. No runs and two left on base for the runners. We head to the bottom of the eighth, GCU leading 8-3. West Side Story, the classic tale of a turf war between rival teenage gangs, opens in Ethington Theater on March 31st. The final Ethington Theater performance of the year is a spin on Romeo and Juliet and has been captivating audiences for decades, and this production will be no exception. Get your tickets now at gcu.edu/west. Submarine thrower out there for CSU Bakersfield. Get you a number here soon. Looks like number 21, Nathan Dewsnap, 6'4 junior from Norco, California. Snap enters the game for Mazup didn't pitch too amazingly, but didn't pitch too poorly either. Snap enters the game with a 3.31 ERA. This is his 10th appearance. He has 4 saves on the season in 16 and a third innings pitch, gives up 18 hits, 6 earned runs, 6 total runs as well. Strikeout 22 and walked 2. Faced 70 batters and opponents are hitting 277 against him. Austin Bull will lead things off here for GCU, having a day. A walk, a single and a double and a run scored with an RBI. Solid stat line for the leadoff batter for GCU. And we'll lead things off here again in the eighth. Austin Bull faces off against the sidearm thrower with a set position that's pretty low and a weird arm angle and a weird arm slot. Throws the first pitch over the plate for a strike. Sometimes facing a new pitcher with a different arm angle can be difficult, but GCU does have a submarine thrower in AJ Franks, so nothing new here. Dewsnap shakes off a snine, will come set. The delivery fouled off. Into the glove of Ortega. Robles is in right field. Kono goes to second base. Ortega is still behind the plate. Pitch inside, ball one. GCU trying to solidify the sweep here against Bakersfield. Be the second straight series sweep against Bakersfield for GCU. Sweeping Bakersfield last year on the road. Bottom of the eighth here. GCU just needs one more inning. And GCU just needs to hold Bakersfield to under 5 runs. Another ball. Full count here for Bull, who started things off in the at-bat. Down 0-2. GCU will face off against the number nine batter, and then back to the top of the lineup will be Bakersfield's last-ditch effort to salvage a game. Bulls staying alive here in this at-bat, fouling that one off. Hitting 381 on the season. 6-11 as leadoff guy. The 3-2. Ground ball left side. Grosjean is there. Takes it at the stomach, and the throw over to first base is on target this time to record the first out of the inning. Brings up LaRouge. LaRouge is 2-for-3 today, hitting 341 on the season. Singled in the first and scored, doubled in the fourth. Two RBIs to his name as well. Has reached base three times today. Comes inside, ball one. And numbers, if you like to see if you're Andy Stankiewicz, is the fact that GCU's 10-for-19 with runners on base today, 6-for-13 with runners in scoring position, and 4-for-9 with two outs. GCU battling every at-bat this game, and it shows on the scoreboard as well, scoring 8 runs. 10-for-19 with runners on base means that GCU's not getting on base for naught. The 1-1 from Doosnap is grounded at the second baseman, Kono. We'll throw over to first base for out number two.
First baseman, Ian
Kono
Evans.
Didn't make it look super easy the way he fielded that ball to his left side. But either way, he was able to record it out, and that's all you can ask for if you're interim head coach Beard. First pitch to Ian Evans is outside for ball number one. Doosnap's career high in innings pitches, 2 2/3 innings coming against Nebraska. Most recently, gave up 4 hits in that game, 2 runs. They were both earned. Strikeout 5 against Utah. It's career high in strikeouts. Has a 2-0 count here against Ian Evans, and GCU hasn't been able to get a hit off Doosnap yet. 2 outs here in the bottom of the 8th. Ground ball left side. Kono's there this time again. That one looks a lot easier, and it's 3-up, 3-down here in the 8th. GCU unable to score any more runs. It's 8-3. Heading to the 9th inning, GCU looking to sweep the series. We've got a closer coming out for GCU. We'll see you here for the top of the 9th here on GCU TV just after this short break.
There's an exciting new destination for food, fun, and relaxation in the heart of Phoenix. Come to GCU Hotel and Canyon 49 Grill, where our hospitality management students gain hands-on workplace experience and deliver unmatched service right alongside the staff. Enjoy beautiful amenities like the resort-style pool and full-service fitness center. From the gaming lawn and patio to the artisanal coffee and teas of GCBC, you'll never want to leave. Room rate $79 per night. Visit GCUhotel.com to book your visit today.
Get the duties as the closer here today, trying to put the poor pitching outing against New University of New Mexico behind him. Malachi has a 14.14 ERA. This is his 8th appearance. He's pitched 7.0 innings. 6 walks, 4 strikeouts. Opponents are hitting .444 against him. He has an 0-2 record. And he can try to get on the right foot here with a 5-run cushion. Bakersfield will send Ortega, and then the top of the lineup to the plate in Pena and Penner. that Pena and Penner haven't been producing at the top of the lineup. They're 0 for 8 today combined. Both are 0 for 4. Ortega is 0 for 1 today. Excuse me, he hasn't had an at-bat. The number 9 batter for CSU Bakersfield is 0 for 3 today. Felix struck out in the second, then flew out to center twice, once in the fourth and once in the seventh. So this will be Ortega's first at-bat of the game. No hits between the three batters due up for Bakersfield. Bobby Mulacki will hopefully use that to his advantage. The first pitch from Mulacki. Great fastball with a lot of velocity behind it for strike number one. Mulacki gets a sign from Meyer. Comes set and delivers. Almost got him. 1-1 now after that pitch was high and inside. Ortega, check your chin. You might have less facial hair on your face now after that one came in on the chin. Might have shaved off some. That one's in the dirt, 2-1. Mulacki's first pitch was beautiful, and then the next two have been all over the place, one up high and inside, and the next one low and outside. All three fastballs. 2-1. Another fastball, this one belt high for strike number two. Bakersfield didn't like it. Neither did their fans. Looks pretty good. And I'm a proponent of keeping the strike zone and a belt mid to lower torso to the knees. Strike three called. Bobby Mulacki gets him looking for the first out of the inning. Brings up the top of the lineup with Mark Pena. First pitch is inside to Mulacki, from Mulacki to Pena. Bobby Mulacki comes set, the 1-0. That one's in there for a strike. The 1-1 from Mulacki. Low and outside. Jack Schneider set his team up for success here, going 5 full innings, only giving up 2 runs on 3 hits. Benavides again gave up 3 hits, and Smith gave up 2. We're in the ninth now, and Mulacki is trying to cement the game and the series sweep. That one comes inside. It's 3-1 now. A 3-1 pitch from Mulacki. All fastballs so far from the reliever out of Lake Havasu City. Stay tuned after the game, folks, for interview with head coach Andy Stankiewicz after the series. Bobby Mulacki with another strikeout here, getting Pena swinging this time. Two up, two down, all from strikeouts. Brings up Andrew Penner. We'll chat with Stankiewicz after the series and what looks like a series sweep here for GCU. Good breaking ball there to Penner. GCU taking all three games. Jack Schneider, fantastic performance, throwing 5 innings. And Ty Wyatt, 2 great games in a row. Penner puts one in to left field, keep his team alive. Brings up the third baseman, David Metzger, the right-handed batter. The senior will step in with two outs in the inning and a runner at first base, down five. First pitch is in there for a strike. Bobby Mlacki hasn't thrown a lot of off-speed pitches, but when he has, they've been for strikes. Bobby Mlacki with a lot of velocity. Could get more opportunities as a closer with good run, good cushions. Runner takes second base on indifference. And it is a final. Oregon State takes it over Arizona 11-7. Four runs in the eighth for Arizona. It's going to be a tough matchup for GCU down in Tucson, but they'll battle. Andy Stankiewicz instilling that mentality in all of his teams. Mlacki walks. Base runner there.
First baseman Max Carter.
Metzger's on first base. Runners on first and second for Max Carter. Scored two runs today. One single, two walks, and a fielder's choice. Two outs in the inning. Max Carter trying to keep his team alive, down five with an 0-1 count. Swings at the 0-1 pitch, it's 0-2 now, and GCU's a pitch away from ending the ball game, ending the series, and sweeping CSU Bakersfield. There is movement down in the bullpen for GCU. The pitch from Mlacki's in the dirt, smothered there by Meyer, does well to keep that one in front of him. That 1-2 fouled off. Staying alive is Carter and the runners here in this ball game. And after today's performance, Ty Wyatt might be the WAC hitter of the week. Two back-to-back three-hit games. And unless a Northern Colorado or Chicago State players had anything fantastic, which could have happened the way that they played, Ty Wyatt might win it. The 1-2 to Mlacki, lifted to right. Garrison Schwartz is there, and that's the ball game. GCU sweeps Bakersfield, winning the Sunday game 8-3, putting up 14 hits in the ball game. GCU sweeps Bakersfield for the second time in 2 years. Great performances all around. Jack Schneider have a day, five innings pitched. He gets the win. Two earned runs against him, giving up three hits, striking out four, only walking one. Great performance from the freshman in just his second start. Benavides then came in and threw two innings of scoreless baseball, gave up three hits. Jeremy Smith came on in relief for an inning, and then Mlacki finished things off. Jack Schneider finishes with five innings pitched, three hits, two runs, they were both earned. Benavides finishes two innings pitched, three hits. Jeremy Smith throws an inning, gives up two hits and a run. It was earned, a walk and a strikeout. And Mlacki comes in to close it out, gives up one hit, strikes out two, hits a batter as well. But GCU wins the series, and Jack Schneider gets his first win of the season and of his GCU collegiate career. In his second start, his first conference start of the season and of his career. Great performances all around from GCU players. Five GCU players with multi-hit games. Josh Meyer, 3 for 4. Garrison Schwartz, 2 for 3. Ty Wyatt, 3 for 4. Tom LaRouge, 2 for 4. And Austin Bull, 2 for 4. Great hitting performances from the entire GCU lineup here today and the entire series, essentially, minus that first game where GCU's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 batters went 0 for 18. But Bull and LaRouge stepped up big. Bull's been a bull all season long, getting on base any way he can, hitting 376 on the season. Josh Myers boosted his batting average to 350, going 3 for 4 today with an RBI and a run scored. He was left on base twice. And we'll have head coach Andy Stankiewicz up here shortly chatting with the team right now. As you can see, and we'll run you through scores around the country here shortly. Number 7, Clemson beating Boston College 2-0. Miami upsetting North Carolina 6-2. South Carolina beat Alabama 4-2. These are all top 25 scores. Michigan beat Maryland 6-2. Michigan's 18th in the country. Number 20, Auburn beat Georgia 4-1. Number 21, Virginia beat Duke 13-6. Number 3, Texas Tech beat Wichita State 3-1. St. John's, number 17 in the country, smacked Maine 15-1. Top 15 matchup between LSU and Florida. LSU beating Florida 10-6. Oregon State, the number 1 team in the country, beating Arizona 11-7. TCU beat Oklahoma State 5-1. TCU's 4th in the country. Number 12, Stanford beat Utah 1-0. We'll run through some WAC scores here as well as we wait for Stankiewicz to get up here. Andy Stankiewicz on his way up here, waiting on Josh Hauser, SID, to go grab him. Utah Valley beats UT Rio Grande Valley 4-1 in 10. Northern Colorado comes back to beat Sacramento State 8-7 to sweep the series against the preseason number 3 team. And GCU beats Bakersfield 8-2. It's going to be a matchup of two undefeated teams in conference between Northern Colorado and GCU next weekend here at Brazos Stadium. You can catch all those games here on GCU TV. Michael Potter will have the calls. And New Mexico is trailing UC Santa Barbara so far. It's 6-0 in the bottom of the 7th inning. UC Santa Barbara has runners on first and second right now. So where does that put GCU in the conference? Well, 3-0, and Northern Colorado at 3-0. We're tied for first with Northern Colorado, who was picked to finish 8th in the conference. So it'll be a good matchup between two ball clubs next weekend. You won't want to miss any of them. Ryan Grotejohn finished 3 for 4 today. Four of the runners had 2 RBIs. Sergio Robles also batted in a runner for the runners. Max Carter went 1 for 3 with 2 runs scored. And David Metzger scored the other run for the runners. Austin Bull went 2 for 4, as we said. Tom LaRouche did as well. GCU, 14 hits, 8 runs scored, 7 RBIs. Only struck out 3 times and walked twice. Bakersfield struck out 7 times. GCU's pitching coming to life this series, being able to close out games. It's something we haven't been able to talk about earlier in the season. GCU's bullpen was a bit of a liability for most of the season. Waiting on Stankiewicz. He's walking up the steps right now. And we'll chat with him here shortly. As we welcome Stankiewicz into the press box, here. We'll wait for him to get a headset on, but GCU sweeps the series over CSU Bakersfield, and good performances all around. As congratulations, coach, you sweep the series over CSU Bakersfield, your second series sweep against Bakersfield in a row. Last year, sweeping them on the road. And Jack Schneider, what do you think about him? Great performance, five innings pitched, and didn't really have anything that you could say bad about him except for the first inning where he got two outs and then let some runs cross. But other than that, settled down pretty quickly and was a bulldog out there.
No, he did a nice job. That's kind of what we saw in high school, you know, over here, a local boy at Bashan. So he's always been a pretty competitive kid. You know, sometimes it's those nerves. You know, you got to just take a deep breath and relax and trust your stuff and trust your defense. And but you're right. That once he kind of got out of that first inning, and hope it looked like he just kind of got his breaking ball over for a strike, that's going to be important as he develops his game, is being able to throw that breaking ball and change it for a strike as well. And so it kind of can keep, obviously, hitters off balance. But he did a nice job after that first inning, absolutely.
Yeah, it looked like he shied away from that breaking ball in the first inning, but then in the third and the fourth, he came at batter's first pitch with that breaking ball, and they were not expecting it at all because they hadn't seen it all game so far, and he was able to keep batters off balance with those breaking ball pitches. And Josh Meyer, 3-for-4 today, great performance from him, pushes batting average to .350. What have you liked from him so far
in
the series?
Josh brings an energy and, you know, to our ball club. He's been here, you know, for a while, so he kind of knows what we're trying to do out there on the field. And he wants to win. He's a very competitive young man, and it's important to him. You know, sometimes he can be a little out of control, and he knows that, but he's done a really good job of just kind of making the pitching staff kind of his, and, like, you know, kind of that mentality with them. And so he's worked really well these past two games, and so you know, we're going to need that. We're going to need Barnes, we're going to need McDonald, we're going to need all those guys. We've got a long way to go, but certainly great job by Josh here this past couple games.
He was able to step in. You saw him go out to the mound multiple times, settle down with Schneider, the freshman. That seniority, even though he's a redshirt junior, really showing behind the plate, being able to manage a game well, and that's what the catcher does. They have to manage a game.
Yeah, exactly. Like I said, he's been around. He understands. He's catching bullpens with these guys every day, and so he knows what their pitches are and what's working, and he does a really nice job of trying to get guys to settle down. And then at the same time, if guys need a little kick in the tail, he's not afraid to be pretty verbal and make sure they get moving in the right direction.
Somebody that doesn't need a kick in the tail, Ty Wyatt, two back-to-back three-hit games for Wyatt. What have you liked from Ty Wyatt so far?
Well, he's versatile. You know, obviously we had him at third today. He can play left, and he can play second. He can play just about anywhere on the field. And so, obviously, we love his versatility. You know, that we can, you know, Zach Malis, we'll give him a little bit of day off today, and we'll get him back in there again on Wednesday. I love his versatility, and his Tyler's always been kind of a groove guy, you know, a rhythm guy, and he's certainly in a good spot right now, and we got to make sure that we continue to get him some at-bats. But he's got a nice little line drive stroke, and he's using the middle of the field really well. And so, you know, I think that's going to be key for him, is just understanding who he is and just taking the ball back up the middle.
Another person that has a great swing back up the middle is Austin Bull. Has been an amazing leadoff batter for you, hitting over 600 in the leadoff spot all season long. Anything you need to work on with Austin Bull?
Well, no, Austin just, he knows himself. He knows how to go deep in counts. You know, he does a nice job of making the pitcher work a little bit. And so he's got a nice eye. You know, he doesn't chase out of the zone very often. He's just a guy that understands his swing and tries to stay flat through the zone and hit line drives. And I was talking to Josh yesterday. Yeah, as he gets older, he'll start to put a jolt in the ball a little bit more. But right now, he understands who he is and just tries to hit line drives all over the field.
That's all you can ask for. And you kept Grotjohn and Penner relatively quiet all series. What was the approach with them, and what was the team able to do successfully against two hitters that are really potent and can flip the switch really quickly?
Well, I think both of them, you know, we try to stay away and just try to stay from their strengths a little bit. And Grotjohn did a heck of a job at short, man. He made some plays after plays after plays. He took some hits away from Austin all weekend. So he's a nice little player. So congrats to him and wish him the best moving forward. But, I think with this team, they can swing it. I think you got to make good pitches. You got to be able to, you know, establish your fastball away and then sneak another one back in there. just try to keep them off balance. And I think our pitching staff did a nice job moving the ball in and out on those two guys, like you said, because they can swing the bat.
Got Arizona midweek this week. They got swept by Oregon State, lost today. What is going to be the approach for in-state team like Arizona that's ranked in the top 25 this week?
Well, we're just going to go down and you know, obviously enjoy. We're very excited to go down and play down in Tucson. They're a great program. You know, they've done a great job. I mean, historically, forever. So they're very good, you know, and they're going to be hungry. I didn't know they got swept this weekend, but they're well coached. They got some skilled players. Just going to go down there and just be aggressive and get after it and see what happens.
Last question. You have Northern Colorado next weekend at home. Two teams that are undefeated in WAC play came back against Sacramento State today to win an 8-7 late in the game. It's going to be the battle of two undefeated teams in the WAC. What can we expect from GCU against Northern Colorado, who wasn't expected to start or play this well all season?
Well, they're physical. You know, we went down their place last year. They're strong. They recruit a big physical player, and so you got to make pitches. Anytime you're facing a lineup like that that's got strong men, you got to make pitches. And so it's going to be up to us to make some nice pitches, and I'm sure they're going to have some nice confidence coming into this series. You know, taking three from Sac State, which is very, very difficult to do. Sac State's a great program, and so obviously they're swinging the bat pretty well to do what they did this weekend. So we're going to have to make some pitches.
Awesome. Well, thank you, Coach. Congrats on the win. Congrats on the series sweep against CSU Bakersfield, and good luck the rest of the season and this week against Northern Colorado and Arizona.
All right. Thanks, Fletcher. Appreciate it.
Yep. And thank you to all of our viewers here for tuning in to the series finale between the two teams here. And the Lopes are heading down to Arizona to face off against the Wildcats this week. You can tune in to that game. Follow it on GCULopes.com, and then Northern Colorado next weekend on the 31st. You can follow that on GCU TV. I'm Fletcher Like. For the entire crew, thank you. You can follow Grand Canyon University on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/GCU. Have a great afternoon. Enjoy your Sunday, and go Lopes.